Hello and welcome to the Business Roundup for this week. My name is Bailak Sasia and on set with me is Paul Busharizi. We are digesting the biggest events that happened during this business week. And also remember to always catch this every Friday on the news. So Paul, we start off with the Bank of Uganda. The Bank of Uganda Deputy Governor spoke about the bank maintaining the lending rate at 10%. So what does this mean for the business community?
So it's called the central bank rate, and it's an indicator of the cost of money to banks. So banks use that rate as a measure of how they are going to price their loans to the public. So it's important to us because the banks take a cue from the central bank on how to price their lending rates. So, but this is an important figure also because it tells us what the Bank of Uganda foresees in terms of inflation. I think the Bank of Uganda now has kept the CBR rate stable or steady at 10%, I think, since the beginning of the year. That means their research shows that inflation is not a big risk. Okay, not that it's not a big risk. They don't see it going up much further than it is now in the near future. So it's also a good indicator for like people to know that inflation kind of is going to remain steady or reduce.
So during the same report, the deputy governor spoke about geopolitics affecting business growth in Uganda and the economy in general. So we still have the war in Ukraine going on and several other things popping up around the world. So what does this mean for the economy and how stable can we be as long as these events continue to happen?
Yeah, so the Bank of Uganda is in charge of monetary policy in Uganda, and basically that is the supply of money in the economy and things surrounding supply of money in the economy. So inflation at a very basic level happens when too much money is chasing too few goods. So the Bank of Uganda, what it does in such circumstances, it sucks out excess money from the economy. It does this in several ways. One, of course, is the CBR rate. The CBR rate, as I said, dictates to the banks what they can lend at. If they raise the CBR rates, the banks raise their lending rates and fewer people borrow. So supply of money is affected that way. Second thing they do is they sell bonds, bills and treasury bills and bonds to the public. Essentially, they borrow from the public. But what they are doing essentially is just sucking that money out of the public where it can cause inflation. And then, you know, they can do things like buying shillings using dollars or sell dollars, whichever way you look at it. They're either selling dollars to the public or buying shillings from the public to reduce supply of money. So those are the decisions the bank has been doing, which it takes on a literally a daily basis. And so when he says that inflation is down because of that, I think the Bank of Uganda is largely responsible.
Now, one other factor, Paul, that was pointed out by the central bank that will affect economic growth in Uganda is the cut on the oil output by OPEC member countries. So what is it like? What really happened with the oil production? Why do we have it coming down to almost a standstill? What's going on, and let us know how this is going to affect us as a country.
What has happened is we are in a better place than 1 year ago when the war started, because we have learned how to adjust. We've adjusted ourselves to the supply chain. You know, we're using different supply chains, or we're using alternatives to wheat in many places. And so we're obviously better off than we were a year ago when the war started.
And Paul, yesterday in very dramatic events, we had the Minister for Karamoja Affairs appear in court over the stolen iron sheets. And so I was just intrigued, you know, to ask, do you think this is going to address the corruption issue we have in the country? And how ably can the government be able to handle projects and not let down the citizens, especially for the whole country watching and following these events?
Well, I think the charging of Karamoja Affairs Minister Mary Chitutu is a good thing, if only because it makes the corrupt pause before they dip their fingers in the till, or so we hope. They might have such impunity that they don't care. They just, you know, as soon as she's off to Luzira, they're still going and hammering the case. But we would like to believe that, you know, it makes them pause a bit. And it probably also dissuades others who are not yet corrupt becoming corrupt. So we are hoping that that's what it is. She's one of several ministers and public officials who are being investigated on the thing. She just happens to be like the, I don't know whether you can call it, alleged kingpin of the whole racket. But we can expect in coming days that more people will be brought before court.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure having you on this interview, and we shall see you again next week. And thank you so much, our dear viewer, for joining us for this business roundup. Be sure to catch the latest of the business events happening in Uganda every Friday here on the news. I am Viola Xatia. Until next time.